I'm Jimi Hendrix, and this is episode 132, Visionquest on Empower Your Pattern. Did you know that there are success patterns to help you receive more, to help you live and enjoy a better and extraordinary life right now? Well, I'm Jimi Hendrix. I am a success, confidence, and thrive coach, adversity authority, self-published author, a member of the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints, and I'm here to give you these success patterns. Let's go. Okay. We're getting down to some pretty exciting moments. Early May, 1997. It's around the time of final exam time. Keith arrives the Thursday before final exam starts. I have been studying all day because I knew in some ways the weekend would involve some fun times. And then he came. We listened to some music. We played some dice game. And then I told him about a place that I like to go sometimes to dream build. It's a lecture hall at Texas Tech. I'm not sure it's around anymore, but it is in my dreams, in my layout. And the thing is, I told Keith, I said, I would love to take you and bring you down into the lecture hall. My concern is, I don't think you can take the walk. He says, no, Jimmy, I wouldn't. Describe it for me. I said, okay, you're on the ground floor. You walk into the entrance hallway of the Mass Communications building. It's back in the old days. But I don't think it's like that at all nowadays. Anyway, you walk in there and you hang a little lift. And then there's two big doors. One on the far right and one on the far left of that entrance hall you're facing. You go through one of those and you go down the stairs until the desired row where you sit and watch the lecture. My place to go, you know, being legally blind and everything, was down front. And so I would go there sometimes to dream build. Because, as you know, I was trying to work on my business with my ex-wife Chris, and my friend and sponsor Kelly, from me and Chris, suggested I find ways to dream build, even if it means without her. And so that's what it was like at first. You know, we were just a month and a half to a month shy of the wedding, and Keith told me, he said, Jimmy, you can't achieve your dreams. And he reminded me of something he had mentioned back in February. You know, the episode 128, Shove Me, Fly That Ship. Now, I'll tell you something. I remember coming back from my first final exam. It's a Friday night. Political analysis. You know, Gregor Morse class. And I was like sweating bullets. When I came back that night, I remember Keith gave me a pat on the back. He's like, all right, you did it. You did it. He said, you're going to pass that class, Jimmy. He said, you might make a C, but you'll pass that class, no problem. You'll pass that class. And then after that, I don't think I had a final. I think my next final was on, I think I had a political theory final on Saturday. And then a political philosophy on an American presidency on Monday. And then, of course, the constitutional law final, which was the final one. And Keith was always telling me, he's like, Jimmy, I know you're struggling a lot with this 9-month depression. He said, but don't let it get you down. Don't let it get you down. And even Keith's mom, Sarah Moore, she's like, Jimmy, son, you need to get into a right church. Get into a good church where, you know, where your church leaders can lead you to good counseling. And that was my intent. Meanwhile, at the same time, I'm fighting for a computer with the State Agency for the Blind, and the caseworker, Miss Bleschnauer, says no way. Our evaluators say no way. You got a 2.1 GPA. You don't deserve it. There's no way. No way. And Keith would tell me, Jimmy, these are your rights. I don't care if you have to contact the National Federation of the Blind. You're going to do something about it, and you're going to fight for your rights, okay? You're going to fight for your rights. Now, when I came back, you know, and having to do all this stuff, you know, fight for the computer, get the marriage license, go through last bit of pre-marriage counseling, it was nerve-wracking. And I remember coming home from all that one day, and my ex-wife said, I threatened Miss Bleschnauer with calling a lawyer. I grabbed her, I said, come on, there's a better way to deal with this. I said, you forced my hand in this. Okay, and this is like, I think, it was 4 days, I think, before the wedding. And I looked up, I got the homepage for National Federation of the Blind, NFB of Texas. I contacted their state affiliate leaders. 4 days later, I got the computer. But that's here and there. Sometimes, when you get knocked down, and you get knocked down, and things get overwhelming and burnt out, and you get knocked down, sometimes you gotta find that vision and fight for it. It's like my good friend that comes to see me as an aide 3 times a week. She tells me, she's like, Jimmy, don't give up so easily. Don't give up so easily. So I'm telling you this. Don't give up so easily. You are made for more. You're made to do more. You're made to be more. Think of the vision that God has put inside you. You can do this, folks. And to think, while some of my other friends were complaining, Keith patted me on the back. He's like, Jimmy, you won. You won that battle. May not be necessarily the computer you wanted, but you won. You know, my more reactive friends in the old days were complaining, but Keith compensated. Because he was the man around that time that was leading me back to my Visionquest. And I hope you find this helpful. We hope you've enjoyed listening to Empower Your Pattern 2.0. If you like what you hear, please subscribe. Become a citizen of Pattern Realm. This is Jimi Hendrix saying until next time, don't just sit there and take it. Build your dreams so you can take it. Do it as don't so you can be with us won't. Do it as don't so you can have it as can't. Choose, act, and pursue happiness. Once again, share this with Mama-san, Papa-san, and everyone. Choose, act, and pursue happiness. And God bless you.